Oh, that's not even the right account. Oh, okay. All right. That's the problem over here. I don't know why Gmail decided that right now was the best time to sign me out from all of my devices. So we have 2048 monthly working, which is really fun. There's about three things that I actually like really have to do before this is like a game that I can just hand somebody play. So let's see. If we cargo run this, we have to do it with nightly. There's actually one other thing that I wanted to try. Cargo plus nightly run. So this is our 2048 so far. Put it in the left-hand corner so that my face isn't covering it. And it works. Like, we get stuff. There's something weird about the GUI layout with Bevy, where like if you do stuff like this with the button and whatnot, it'll just kind of like lay over other things. Like, it would be nice to fix that, but also, I don't know. Like, I get the feeling that it's supposed to be a HUD and not supposed to be, because it's a different layer, right? Like, the board is on like the game layer with the game camera, and then the UI is on a different layer with the UI camera. So you can't get them to match each other unless you like lay something onto the UI that is exactly where the game board would be. It's a little weird. Probably the Bevy docs, right? Bevy in gigantic letters. Okay, so yeah, we got three things to do today. I probably want to get rid of the debugs in here so that we don't see a bunch of them. Am I print lining? Yeah, I'm print lining. The other problem is I think Rust Analyzer decided to die today and not be around. Yep, failed to read cargo metadata. That's a new one. Oh well, maybe I need to update. Maybe that'll get Rust Analyzer to work. Okay, so this is about 800 lines of code right now. It's quite a bit. I mean, it's mostly like the board shift function repeated four times, I think. I think that takes up the majority of the lines, like, let's see, 757. So yeah, the board shift function is like 300 lines of code, 350. That's quite a bit. It feels like we should be able to like abstract this, but also the function is kind of dependent on the ordering of the things. And then, so yeah, we've got a couple of things to do. So I guess instead of abstracting this, because I think I'm going to leave abstracting this to be like off stream at some point, because it feels like it's going to be a little bit weird. And it's mostly me going to be me staring at that function. I think we'll do the game end condition or scoring. Scoring is a good one. Scoring will involve adding a new event to the system. Are we in the middle of adding the new, we've got our button system, new tile event. I guess we've already added the button system. We might as well add like the reset game event. I don't think that we have a struct for that. So we will reset game event. I'm gonna need to pull this apart into different like places because having it all in one file is kind of icky. Not great. Okay, so we've got a reset game event. I don't think we have like a click handler or anything on the button yet. So we need to figure out how to add that. Let's boost this, see a bit more of this. So we're spawning this button bundle. The size and the styling is a little bit like CSS. The last time we worked on 2048, we figured out that it was kind of like reverse. So flex start is the opposite side that you would expect it to be, and flex end is the opposite side. But we do get to size things in pixels. I'm not sure how the pixels translate in terms of like how big this margin is compared to other things, but we will figure it out. Or actually, we probably won't figure it out today. We don't need to. So we've got the button, we've got the text on the button. So let's go figure out how to add like a click handler onto this. This is our button system interaction query. Maybe we do have this here, interaction query clicked. Yeah, so we do have a clicked here, and then we can just send the event here. Let's figure out how we're sending our other event. I don't remember exactly how we're doing that. Tile writer, event writer, text query. So in button system, we're gonna need this interaction query, and then we're gonna need a, not a new tile event, but a reset game event. And I can already see that I'm gonna regret having put this in a separate file, but that's okay. Maybe we'll start splitting out our events into a new file. I always thought the pixels use Google Translate. Okay, Xander. That's gotta be Xander. Okay, so event writer. And then actually using the event writer, if I remember correctly, is super easy. Of course, it's all the way down on line 770, whatever. Yeah. And then we just send it. Full send. Clicked. Material. It's not title writer. It is reset game writer. And we send the reset game event. And then we need like a reader. and we can iterate over the reader. This feels a little weird, but I think that we only end up getting like, well, in any case, we need to go figure out what event reader is, but I think the implementation of iter for event reader and the way that the ECS works will just give you the next one on each tick kind of thing. So we need to basically copy paste that line and then operate on it. Where are we going to put the reset game handler? Because basically that needs to call the initial like setup board function and clear all the blocks out. What's our function call for spawn tiles? Spawn tiles is the original tiles. So I wonder if we can just call spawn tiles. It is just like this function, which is a little weird, but maybe we can just call it because it is a function. All right, let's do game reset system. And then in our game reset system, we'll have this kind of a query. We probably need command. So we need everything that we're going to get from spawn tiles, I think, if we're going to try to call this function. We at least will need commands anyway, I believe, because if we want to like run a startup system kind of thing. So let's do this and then let's query the blocks maybe, because we're going to have to despawn all the blocks. So let's go query the blocks. I think this is where I despawn them. Mute blocks. This is a lot of queries. I think that's okay, but we could probably pare this down a bit. First thing we need to do when we reset game is game reset.system. I'm just gonna copy this up because that's the easiest thing to do, game reset. So here we do tile reader on the iter and then we get the next value. And if it's a something, then we do something. If it's nothing, then we do nothing. This isn't tile reader though. This is, this is gonna be awkward. I renamed it, didn't I? I need to choose one or the other. Let's do game reset reader and let's do game reset. Let's do noun verb and just commit to that. So that should overall compile now because I don't think I broke anything. Restart the Rust Analyzer server, see if updating nightly helped. It did not. I don't know what's going on there. You know what I probably have? I probably have a VS Code update or something waiting for me. It's always a VS Code update. Okay, so game reset reader iter next is sum. So we will only participate in this block if that is the case, at which point we need to iterate over blocks. Iter dot maybe like for entity. I don't think we need transform or position or changed. I think we just need entity. And then we're also actually going to have to despawn the text. So let's start with blocks and then we'll move on to text. No, Rust Analyzer is my document formatter. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, that feels so bad. For entity and blocks iter. Okay, system not method not found in button material, not found in the scope. Game reset reader is not found in the scope, right? Because I didn't name it that. I named it tile reader in the argument. The compiles are pretty fast once you get into it. Like the incremental compiles. Reset game event, we will need to pull that in. So let's figure out how to do that first. Reset game event. I could import it from button. Is button a button doesn't feel like a good place for that event though. Like I guess it's okay. And it would solve all of our problems really easily. But I almost feel like we should have an events module. So maybe we'll do that. Let's create a new file called events. Man, mistyping everything today. So these will be pub. And then in buttons, we can use events star. Well, we don't need event star. We need game reset event, which I think is the wrong way to access that. Remove these parentheses. Yes, that is a single element tuple. We do not need it to be there. We will import that from create. Create events, game reset event. So now we have our events over here. There's not much here. Like, I'm not sure we need a file for the events. It is kind of nice to have them separated. But there, like I said, there isn't anything here. Maybe if we like put the game reset event in there or the game reset system in there. I feel like the systems in Bevy have to query so many things that it doesn't really make sense for like the game reset system to necessarily live in the events or like the new tile system to live in the events. I don't know. We'll find out. Scaling Bevy code maintenance. Let me reset the Rust Analyzer server. Did I already try this? I did. So we've got our blocks. We've got our entities. And remove this. I don't think we need this anymore. See what we've got here. Our button system is still having issues. That's because we messed something up. Reset game event can't be found. Oh, that's weird. Oh, right. Because that's what I named it. Duh. I'm running into the problem that I knew I would run into earlier. Let's do game reset event. And then let's get rid of this big.toml and do, yeah, game reset event. Do I have reset game in here? I do have reset game in here. Select everything with command D, game reset event, and then that should compile. Reset game event is still being added as system in main. So game reset, reset game. I said it wrong is what happened. Game reset event. And then we run and we're running. When we click this, nothing happens because it doesn't do anything, which is fine because we'll make it do something. So now we're good. We have our button set up. Let's do like debug resetting game. And then when we run this, we should be able to click and see that debug out in the console output, but we cannot. So why is that happening? Or why is that not happening? We do have game reset event here. Do this, click, do a little bit of informal debugging. So it does get clicked. I'm assuming that event does get fired. Game reset writer, event writer, game reset event, send game reset event. We get here, so we are sending that. And then, did I not add the game reset system? I don't think I added the game reset system. I did add the game reset system, so it should be running. What is going on here? The game reset command, do this, which shouldn't do anything. It should just output consistently. Like every tick, this function runs and then checks to see all of its stuff. So let's do that. And then we do get clicked. We don't get the event. So I'm not sure why this event isn't firing. That's not good. Event reader. Oh, you know why? Because I have it reading the new tile event. There we go. There we go. That should work. Let's get rid of this like constant debug. And now when we click, we get resetting game. Okay, so we're firing an event on click. Compared to like other UI stuff, it is a little bit awkward, but at the same time, it's an event emitter. So many things in JavaScript are built off this concept of like send an event, receive an event. And I think the only thing that's making it a little bit more awkward is that we have to define our events and we have writers and readers that we need to deal with. Other than that, it's the same concept, right? Like when you click a button and an event fires, that event is handled somewhere and then we do something, right? So despawn is gonna be something like this, real next block dot zero. So we have the ID already. Game reset. So back up in game reset, we've queried for the entity. This can all go on one line. Thank you, Rust Analyzer, for doing that for me. The query system in Bevy is sort of like, we declare what kind of query we want. We say what we want out of that query. So we want an entity that has a block component on it. So we get that full list of all entities that have a block component. We're gonna need commands. I already forgot what I was gonna do. I have to go back and check. Despawn recursive. So back up in game reset, entity comes in as an ID. If you are not familiar with ECS systems, the entity is always an ID. And then there are components, which are blocks that hold kind of like properties and state. And then there are systems which operate on them. So this game reset function is a system. The block component is a block component. And then entity is the ID of the actual entity that is on. So we should be able to do entity here and then despawn recursive. And they should go away except for the text. I think the text won't go away currently. Oh, the text does go away. Perfect. I don't know. There was the other time that I was doing despawn recursive and it wasn't removing the text. And I feel like I have to do something to fix that. But this is great. This is exactly what we want. And it's fairly short and understandable, right? So that's what we're doing. We're querying for all of the block entities. We are reading events off this game reset reader. Whenever we have one, which is what .next is. So when you iterate, when you iter on something, right, a vec or whatever, that's basically giving you this next function. This next function gives you the next item in that iterator, is an optional type. So it's an option of whatever that event is. In this case, we just check, like if we have something, then we continue and we reset the game. We're iterating over all of the entity IDs in this blocks array or blocks vector. And then we get the entity using commands, because commands is kind of like our window into like affecting the environment. And then we despawn recursive on that entity, which we have because we've went and fetched that entity. And that's how we get all of our blocks to disappear. Now, after our blocks disappear, we still need to spawn tiles. So I'm super curious as to if this is going to work, because I've never tried to directly call a system before. It does work. Look at that. That's awesome. That's so nice. We can just keep resetting the game. I'm so happy with that. And then we can play. Yo. All right, so let's get rid of this debug statement. We don't really need it anymore. Don't need this one. Do we still have that one in the button? No, we don't. We got rid of it. Cool. Let me commit this since we have game reset working.